I mean, one of the ways that THX and TAP evolved was back when George came out with his first Star Wars installment. He was very dismayed because a lot of the theaters were not showing it the way that he had made the film. These filmmakers spent so much time getting every shot right, every sound right, and then it goes out to a theater and the sound's muffled, the center channel's out. That's where THX came along, and that's where TAP came along to ensure the best presentation possible for distribution, for the theaters, for everybody.
TAP comes in, gets the job done. They evaluate the prints in the laboratory, making sure that at least we have not veered from the path there. In the theatrical venues, they ensure that the film is shown in the best possible manner. And if it's not, they call us. Hopefully we can try to improve it.
The great revolution that could be happening in the film business the next few years is that more people will see film as it's meant to be presented, one way or the other. So if they see that, I think for a lot of people it's going to be an eye-opening experience.
Well, there was a big cracking subwoofer behind the screen. Anytime major explosions would happen, a loud pop would emanate from it, and it would pull you out of the movie and put you back in the theater. Totally marred the experience, which otherwise would have been quite pleasant.
I've never seen a movie with anything distracting in a THX certified theater.
THX, it's not a sound, it's a sound certification, but it assures quality.
I think that anything as far as sound or anything like that goes, it just, if it's out of whack, it brings you out of the picture and it brings you out of that world.
That's a special thing. You need to be able to hear the film properly, see it properly. You need to be able to be comfortable. You know, that's part of the experience of it. And once theater owners start to lose that completely, they're going to lose their audience.